Hey guys, welcome once again to the Growing Developer channel. This video is in continuation with the first video that you saw. In the first video, we learned how to install Flutter. We got a brief overview of what is Flutter and what does Flutter do. Now, in the last video, we also gave a quick run to our app and we saw that we got this much screen and this was the code that was written and that was given by Google itself. Now we'll dig deep and understand what are widgets, what are stateless widgets and what are stateful widgets. Now let's get an overview of what are widgets in Flutter app. Now widgets are a component. Everything in Flutter is known as widget, be it be text, be it be an app bar, the title of an app bar, any image, any button, everything is widget. Now widgets are broadly classified in stateless widget and stateful widget. Now what is stateless widget? Widget or component that doesn't change its state. State means any color, size, content, etc. For example, let's take an example of this board. Now this board, on this board, whatever is written, right? Now this signboard will not change its state based on time. If a painter paint this board as it is shown in this picture, that will not change its shape, it will not change its size, it will not change its any properties by time. Now what are stateful widgets? Widgets or components that changes its state, that is color, size, content, etc. based on some event like a tap, right? In our app we see that when we tap on some icon or something, it just changes its state, the color, the shape. Now for example, this clock, the needle of this clock is changing its position, that is it is changing its state by the time, right? So other examples of stateless widget, the title in a app bar, the title never changes, or the pages might change and the title might change according to the pages, but for a single page the title is stateless for it. What are stateful widgets? You saw in the example of our app that when we were tapping on the button, the counter was changing. So that was an example of stateful widget. Now let's see our code. Okay, this was where we left on the last video. Now see, the title is not changing wherever I am tapping. Therefore, the title is doing a work of a stateless widget. It is not changing its state. The color is not being changed. But now let's see. If I type on this button, again, you can see the counter is getting changed every time I tap on this button. Therefore, what can we conclude? That this much area comes under stateful widget. Now let's see if we can relate to this concept through this code. We will understand what this code does, but let's first see where is stateless widget and where is stateful widget used. See, now this class my app extends stateless widget, so we can get an idea this whole class is a stateless widget, whereas this homepage class extends stateful widget. So we can conclude that this homepage might be a stateful widget. Now let's see what is inside this homepage. In this homepage we can see an app bar with a title, and in center we have one text and a counter. So this whole area is getting changed, or maybe changed based on some events. I'll give you an example. For example, let's define a color property to our app bar. It takes background color. Let's give it a color green. Now if I save it, you can see the app bar changes its color. Now this was hard coded here. Let's do one thing. I'll take a variable of type color. Let me say that color 1 equals to colors dot green. Don't worry, we'll understand how to declare variables. But for now, just understand this, that this color 1 is holding a value which is colors dot green. Fine. Now can you see where is this counter variable getting updated? Let's search for the function. On pressed function is taking some name. Let's go to the name. Now whenever this button is getting pressed, it is calling this function. Let's do one thing. Inside this function, I'll write that whenever I tap this button, color 1 changes to colors dot blue. Whenever this button will be tapped, the value of color 1 will change to colors dot blue. That is, it will change to blue color. It can be black, it can be brown, it's your choice. Let's check orange. Right now let's save this. Now let's try tapping the button. When I tap this button, nothing gets changed. Why? Because the background color is still colors dot green. So if I write here color 1, now it changes to orange, right? Let's restart it. So as you can see, initially our app bar was having a green color. That is, we declared color 1 equals to green color initially. Fine. Now when I tap on this button, on tap of this button, I declared that this color will change to orange. Now let's see if it is happening or not. When I tap this, see, the color changes from green to orange. Why does this happen? This happened because app bar was also declared under stateful widget. So anything that comes under a stateful widget can change its state. That will be decided by us how it will change its state based on some events. Mostly it is based on some button presses, right? Now to learn more about stateful and stateless widget, you can do self study on, open your browser and go to flutter.dev, go to docs, go to user interface and introduction to widgets, click on adding interactivity to your Flutter. This is for a revision part. Go to the link. I'll also add the link in the description below and just give it a read. You'll have a basic idea what is stateless widget and what is a stateful widget. In the next episode, we will write our first basic app we'll understand how to make an app bar, how to add titles, icons in the app bar, and we'll make a simple app to get you going with the app development. That's all from my side. Thank you once again for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel. Your support means a lot. Goodbye and have a nice day.